I grew up in Johnson City, living four houses down the street from Sarah Jane Johnson United Methodist Church. My mother was a Sunday school teacher, and my father was a perpetual usher. Every Sunday he ushered. So, as a youth, I was very active in the church, president of the MYF, and actually spent 1 year assisting the pastor in Sunday worship. He had very high hopes that I would go into the ministry. From age 6 to 18, I spent my summers working on my cousin's dairy farm. I learned at a young age what it meant to work from 5:30 in the morning to 9 p.m. at night. I was able to milk over a herd of over 100 cows when one of the cousins took time off. Learned how to drive equipment at the age of 9. Before that, I would ride on the back of a large draft horse that was used to pull the farm equipment. So I guess that kind of shows my age, because it's been a long time since I've had horses. As a farm family, we attended church every Sunday. That was very important to them. On graduation from high school, I worked for a year at Endicott Johnson doing piecework. And believe me, I could not make my grade. The harder I tried, I never, cutting coupons was not fun, so never made my grade. That did wake me up and realize that I needed to go to school. So I applied to Broome Community College, and back then it was called Front Street High. So off I went to Front Street High. I was also very active in our church still. Our church had an older youth group, and religious was very important to all of us. A lot of us that were going to Broome Community College all came from Sarah Jane, so it was like a natural, just continued on Sundays doing things. On graduation, my faith became tested. I received my draft notice 2 days on graduation from BCC. Before I knew it, I was off to Fort Dix, New Jersey, and then to Fort Jackson for advanced infantry training. From there, I headed to Vietnam. Within the first 3 days in the field, I watched some of the young men gone over with me get killed as they sat on one hilltop, opposite from the one I was on. These were young men that we all went together from Johnson City. I questioned my faith as I watched the events happen. We were in combat with an enemy who we didn't know. I could still see images of the young children walking toward us, and as they got closer, they'd open up their shirts, and they'd have grenades and different things strapped to their vest. War is hell, especially when you see things like this. Over the next several months, our unit came under numerous mortar attacks. Every one of my unit received shrapnel wounds numerous times. One early morning while our unit was getting ready to leave our foxholes for daily patrol, we came under a severe mortar attack. I received a wound in my back near my spine. I couldn't move. I was helped onto a helicopter and taken to a MASH unit for treatment. As the helicopter began to lift off the ground, another mortar round landed right where the helicopter was. Someone was with me in that moment. We were able to fly out of harm's way. I traveled to several different field hospitals in Vietnam until they finally decided that I needed major surgery to remove the metal from my back. I was put on a hospital airplane and sent to Tokyo for surgery. After several months, I received orders to head back to Vietnam, where I was assigned to pull green line duty. And I just wanted to say, probably during that time in Tokyo, when I received my notice, it happened to be the Tet Offensive in 69, and the unit I was with, if you were wounded 2 times, you were sent back to the United States. They couldn't send anybody back because they needed the troops in Vietnam. I had people in the barracks where we were rehabbing coming around begging to break an arm, break a leg, because they didn't want to go back. I mean, that was just, like I said, war is hell. You don't realize what's going on. One night I received word that I was being reassigned to the DMZ. That's the front line for all the fighting. My faith was once again being tested. Why me? On arrival at the base camp, I was informed I was going to be in charge of the frontline PX or military store, as I had an accounting degree. While assigned there, I became part of a flying PX, where we loaded the helicopter with items and flew out to numerous locations, bringing all sorts of items to the troops in the field. After a tour of 16 months, I was honorably discharged from the Army. I came home at a time when the protests about the war were in full swing. People were not nice about what they said to me. I didn't feel welcome in my own hometown. I couldn't even walk the streets of Johnson City without people saying, you know, what a bad person I was because I was over fighting. I even had people in the church tell me that I was an evil person because of what I had to do in Vietnam. That turned me away from my church. Back then, no one knew about post-traumatic stress. I had a difficult time adjusting and would wake up to nightmares every night. It took several years before I stepped back into the church. I realized that I needed that in my life. Vietnam, or for that matter, any kind of situation, takes a toll on your life. I am proud of what I had to do in the service, and to this day I get choked up when I sing the national anthem. I am proud to have been an American soldier. I salute the men and women who defend our country and those that have lost their lives doing so. Upon leaving the service, I got a job within several months of getting home, and I hated it. Decided to go back to college and was accepted at SUNY Cortland, where I received my master's degree. As a wounded veteran, my college education was paid in full by the government. During that time, I got married, got a full-time job, and had two great children. My marriage failed as the struggles of the past still haunted me. I made some wrong choices. Back then, Pastor Jose came into my life. I happened to live just down the street, and at that time was going to Central, and he was banging on the door every day of the week saying, "Why aren't you coming to Endwell? It's a block away, you couldn't walk." So he helped me through my problems to finally kind of get straightened out. I've been active in this church for 35 years. This is family for me. During this time, my son and daughter were active in this church. I am proud of their accomplishments and their families. I'm also very proud to be part of this vital congregation, to be part of a church that cares about those around us and willing to help those in need. We are a focal point in this community. God bless this church.